put them on the pan. You take the cloth and you roll it up. And you roll it again. Again. Now, we should have the seam on the bottom, right? And we have these ends here that are sticking out. We're going to just... If I was at home, I would use milk. But since I only needed a tablespoon or so, I didn't figure it was worth bringing it along. When water will work as glue, just as easy. Now we're going to flip him back over so the okay, there we've got him pretty well. Now we're rolling back so we pretty much have the seam on the top. Wish the dough had been just a hair more. And I've got way plenty apples in him. And then we're going to bake it on parchment paper. Okay, we'll try it with this side. We got parchment paper here. Put it up against there. You bring the towel. And it's now on the pan, ready for the oven, except that you could moisten the top and put some sugar on it. If you had the big one, when I flipped it over, it would have been hanging off about that far. You simply take your hand underneath it and bring it around. And it will do that without coming apart. Now, we need a second one. So any of you that would like to feel how this dough feels when it's being pulled, I urge you to come up and give it a try. You will find out it is not as difficult to move as you might. Work it out. Roll it over. Press it down. Okay, so before you get to the end, let's water glue that down. Going until you get it seaming way on the bottom. Okay, tucking in. Apples are okay. I tasted one. Going back a little bit. Okay. Now you be careful. Why don't you go on the other side so you can get your picture? Okay, like this from here. Don't worry about this. Yeah.
Roll it on.
Like we've got a little bit more in this one than the other one, but that's the way the apple felt. Now, I'm going to use just a little tiny bit of water on top of it because that's what I do with the milk. Ooh, we don't have an oven that's at 350. How about that? And in a good hour and 15 minutes, we will have. Thank you. Okay. Now you be careful. Why don't you go on the other side so you get your picture? Okay. Like this from here. Don't worry about this. Yeah. Roll it on. Got a little bit more in this one than the other one, but that's way.
1 hour later at 350 degrees.
I don't like them really probably they're hot, but when they're
frozen, you can gnaw on them.
Oh,
so it's got like frozen in there.
So Betty, do you need to let them sit for a little while after they come out of the oven?
Yeah, they're pretty hot.
Yeah.
Something like that. But if they put them on a plate, I expect they'll cool down fast.
You see that? Did you get that email my friend Glenn sends out about the strudels they make at the Catholic Church for Czech Day?
Usually I see all of those, but I haven't looked at anything within the last week, probably. It was one of those weeks where I was gone about every night. Or every day, and right, I was recording.